Sometimes in songwriting, like in so many other things, getting started is the hardest part. We all have habitual ways of going about things. Maybe when we write songs, we start with a riff or we start with an opening line. Some people love to start with a title. I know I was surprised when I went to Nashville for the first time and all these people arrived at writing sessions with books filled with nothing but titles. But it works. But when does a groove become a rut? That's the question, and sometimes you gotta mix it up. Musically, for example, you could start with the chorus. Like Can't Buy Me Love, kind of worked for the Beatles. Or lyrically, whatever your mode is, get out of it. Maybe you could include dialogue in your lyric. I'm a big Steely Dan fan, and most of their songs are fairly obtuse. You kind of know what's going on, but they tell it in such a layered way that you can't say for sure where you are at any given time, and that's fine, I love it. So I was really surprised when the Two Against Nature record came out, and there's a song called What a Shame About Me that is essentially a very straightforward narrative. It tells a story of two people meeting in New York who used to be lovers by accident, and they have a conversation. Most of the song is dialogue. There's a bit of setup. At the beginning of the song, he says, I was grinding through my day gig, stacking cutouts at the Strand, which is a used bookstore in New York, when in walks Franny from NYU. We were quite an item back then. And of course you want to know what's going to happen after that story, but I'll leave you to go back to the song and hear it for yourself. Rodney Crowell, very successful country writer. He's had hits with Emmy Lou, the Oak Ridge Boys, Waylon Jennings and Johnny Cash, was married to Roseanne Cash. And he tells a story about a song that he wrote for the two of them to sing based on one of their life experiences. There's a lot of dialogue in it, as you'll see, and it has to do with two people, former lovers, meeting up in New York. Here's Rodney.
Roseanne found out that I'd never been to a Broadway play. I just casually mentioned it or something, and she like stopped dead in her tracks, all indignant. You know, you call yourself an artist and you've never been to a Broadway play. And so she set about on a mission to get me up to New York to a play. So we went up, she arranged this whole thing, you know, with second row seats to go see this play. It was called Nine. It was 83, I think. And so I went, you know, I was like, okay, you know, let me see what you got for me here. So I went and I was completely washed over by, this plant likes me because it keeps reaching out to take my hand. I got really caught up in the writing aspect of this play, the dialogue, you know, how somebody sat down and thought about writing dialogue. So after the play was over, I was all inspired and thanking Roseanne for giving me that experience and everything. And so I went back to our hotel and I was just sitting there thinking, I want to see if I can write some dialogue in the form of song. So I got in a D, tuned down to D, and I was thinking about two people, you know, maybe who used to be maybe hippies who are now yuppies or whatever, you know, or who used to get by the skin of their teeth, but now were really successful and had money, but had lost their relationship somewhere along the way. And the dialogue that would go on between them when they ran into each other by chance, it was like, fancy meeting you here tonight. It's such a small world, New York ain't my town. I don't come around but once in a while. He's talking to guys. This is such a surprise to see you. Girl, you're looking so good. It's been a long time since you crossed my mind. It's such a small world. And then she would go, just one night on the town, I came looking around. was something to do. And he says, just a change of my plans, only even. And I stay around and I run into you, which just goes to prove it's such a small world. And when I first wrote the song, that's how I was going around and playing it for people, you know, my friends and what have you, and say, you know, I go, he says, da da da, and she says.
Fancy meeting you here tonight. It's such a small world. New York ain't my town. I don't come around but once in a while. This is such a surprise. To see you, girl, you're looking so good. It's been a long time since you crossed my mind. It's such a small world. Just one night on the town, I came looking around for something to do. Just a change of my plans. And I run into you, which just goes to prove it's such a small world.